Welcome to another InMotion Hosting video tutorial. Today, we will be guiding you through how to create a new cPanel account in the WHM interface. Before we begin, we need to go over a few things that you should know before you create a cPanel account. First, if you have more than 5 created cPanel accounts, then there will be an added fee for usage of the cPanel software. You can find more information on our current cPanel pricing here. Second, while it is not absolutely necessary, your cPanel account is normally linked to a domain name. You should have a domain name already registered and pointed to InMotion Hosting. That way you can assign it to the account. If you don't have a domain name at this point, you can use a temporary one for now. You can still access the files through the cPanel, but it will not be accessible via the internet. An example of a temporary domain name could be temp-domain123.com. In order to add a new cPanel account, you will need to be logged in to WHM as either a root administrator or a reseller administrator. If you are not sure what access you have, then please contact your account administrator or the InMotion Hosting technical support team. Let's start the process of creating a new cPanel account. First, you will need to log into WHM. You can get into WHM with your AMP account. Using AMP will bring you directly into the WHM interface without having to retype your username and password. You can also use the direct URL for the WHM interface. For example, in your internet browser, type mydomainname.com/WHM. Or you can also type mydomainname.com:2087. Either of these URLs will bring you to the WHM login screen, where you will need your administrator username and password to log in. When you log in to WHM, you will first see the home screen. You will see a menu on the left-hand side, but you should also see the Manage Your Accounts screen in the main window by default. You can click on Create a New Account in the Manage Your Accounts page, or go to the account functions in the menu and click on Create a New Account. You will then be in the Create a New Account page, and you will see several sections separated by a gray border. It starts with Domain Information. This is where you'll need your domain name as previously noted. If you have a domain name, then type it in. If you don't have a domain name, then make up a temporary one and type it in the domain field. You can always modify it later as needed. Next, you'll need to add a username. Note that the username cannot have spaces or special characters. You will then need to add a password and the email address of the administrator for the account you are creating. You can use the password generator or type one yourself. Make sure to record the password that you use for the account. The next section is labeled as Package. A package is a pre-created configuration for a cPanel account. You can opt to choose an existing package or click on Select Options manually. See the link above for more information on modifying packages. You will then see Settings. It starts with CGI Access. CGI stands for Common Gateway Interface. In general, it is used to allow access for scripts that are to be run on your site. By default, it is checked. The next option is the cPanel theme. There is currently only one theme loaded by default. It's called Paper Lantern. Locale is next. This option will match the language you are using for the site. Click on the drop-down menu to select a different region. And then you have spam prevention options, Spam Assassin and Spam Box. Both of these options are enabled by default. The next section is called Mail Routing Settings. Each option comes with a More link, which will give you an explanation of each setting. If you are using InMotion's mail server, then check Local Mail Exchanger. If you are unsure, then contact the InMotion Hosting Technical Support Team. The following section is called Reseller Settings. If you are letting this account create other accounts, also known as reselling hosting, then you would check the box for Make the Account a Reseller. If you check off this option, then the Make the Account Own Itself becomes selectable. Enable that option only if you are allowing your user to modify the cPanel account in WHM. The final section for creating a cPanel account is called the DNS Settings. The first two options are for email security. DKIM and SPF records help to secure email. After the SPF option, you will see Use the name server specified at the domain's registrar. You should check this option if you are aware that the domain is not registered through InMotion Hosting, and you want to use the name server settings from that registrar. Lastly, the Overwrite Existing DNS Zones option should only be checked if you are aware of the same domain name in another account and you want this particular account to be the active account. This option should be used with caution. If you're unsure, then please contact our live technical support team for assistance. Once you're sure of all your settings, you can click on the blue Create button at the bottom. After you click on the Create button, you will see a screen confirming the successful creation of the account with all of your settings. You will also see a link to the newly created cPanel account. Congratulations! You now know how to create a new cPanel account in WHM. If you want to see your account in WHM, you can go to the menu, click on List Accounts, and then your account will appear in a list. Thanks for watching this video tutorial. If you liked it, please give us a thumbs up below and subscribe to our channel. Thanks again for watching and listening, and have a great day.
Check out our InMotion Hosting Support Center for help with your website. We provide thousands of step-by-step guides, videos, and much more to lead you towards making your online project a successful one. You can find us at www.inmotionhosting.com/support.